Hello sustainable growers, this is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics. In this video, we're going to see the third part of the interview we had with Mr. Peng, who has a commercial size greenhouse in aquaponics. And he's going to give us a lot of information about how to manage disease and especially pests in commercial aquaponics. I hope you're going to enjoy this video, but just before, please subscribe to the channel. And if you haven't done it yet, download your free gift from the description of the video. How do you deal with pests, like insects?
Oh, yes. It's kind of a nuisance, right? The common damage done by insects is aphids.
Yeah.
And the white, tiny moths.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Completely avoid them is impossible, to my opinion.
Okay. Know?
Unless you have a very tightly controlled greenhouse.
Yes.
Yeah. You can use neem oil,
yeah,
mixed with pure soap, liquid pure soap, and mixed with water, about 1 to 10, I believe. Then spread with a spread gun, make it a very fine, like a fog-like spread.
Yes.
Then you will control them. Yeah. They won't do any damage because the very fine little droplet of a mixture will get it between their hair. On the surface of the aphids, they have a very tiny little hair to stop the water getting in. But because the water droplet is so tiny, it will drop in. They will damage the membrane of the insect, and they die.
So if you don't have the good spray gun, it's not going to work.
No. You don't use the normal spray gun. You need a very tiny, like a fog.
Yeah, very thin.
Very thin, right? And then it will work. And for the white moth, they will just dry up. Once they stick on it, they gradually just dry up and they drop off.
Okay. Mm. The other effect is also that the soap is going to stick on the leaf.
Mm.
So then when they want to eat, they're going to be in contact with the soap.
Oh,
anyway,
the soap is only a natural lipid. So gradually they will be absorbed.
Okay.
By the leaf. Or if you have you can wood it down, you can rinse it very easily.
Okay, so for you, it doesn't damage at all your setup. It doesn't
damage
the bacteria.
No.
And you don't have a foam that is into the water,
No. You just spray on the leaf. That will do the job. And most of the time, we don't eat the leaf. Those things grow on, cucumbers, that kind of thing. Beans, that kind of thing. So you don't eat the beans leaf. You don't eat the cucumbers leaf,
Okay. Mm-hmm. And have you got a problem with caterpillars?
Caterpillar, yes. The first thing first is not to let the butterfly fly.
Yeah, that's a good one.
But if you have a caterpillar, there is a product, a natural product, is a type of bacteria.
Yes. So it's organic as well.
Yeah. So it just spread.
So did you use it?
Yeah. It's very effective.
Okay. Otherwise, we got also the black hornet here around.
Black hornet.
Flies that spawn inside the caterpillars.
Yes.
And they are working well, but often you got like 2 weeks between the time you got the caterpillars and the time they come.
Too late.
So you got 2 weeks where basically they eat all your crop.
Yes.
Not all your crop, but a good part.
The revenge is too late.
Exactly, because especially the caterpillars, when they arrive on the tomato, the tomatoes, they grow so fast. But then when the caterpillars arrive, they multiply very quickly as well, right? So that's a challenge. Mm. But I found that the best way was to have a big biodiversity
in
your crop.
Yes, and the biggest problem is the slug.
The slug? You got a problem with that?
Yes, slug. Because the greenhouse provides ideal conditions for slugs. So one way of dealing it is to keep some frogs in.
Oh, okay. Do you?
Yep, I'm going to do it.
You got a big one today. I'm French, you know.
So unfortunately, you know, in this country, the frogs just don't grow big. Because the dry country, they adapt to dry conditions. They're very small, but still they can eat.
They can eat.
Frogs live eat that kind of thing.
And would you eat the frogs? Nah, give it to me.
My suggestion is that you keep a small basin of water.
Yes.
Covered with duckweed.
Yeah. Okay.
Let the frog to multiply in there.
Oh, excellent.
So, in Australia, frogs only need water to breed.
Yes.
They don't really need too much water. You know, they don't actually live in the water.
Yes. Okay.
They're a tough little bugger. So as long as you have that kind of moist environment, they will grow.
Oh, excellent, excellent. Okay. Well, thanks. That's good tips. And in terms of water parameters, how do you check them often?
You have.
If you are watching this video on YouTube, you will see that on the description of the video just below, you will have access to some free gifts. First, you have access to a six-step process to be able to build your own aquaponics system in good conditions. I developed this six-step process because I found that too many beginners are basically starting aquaponics with a wrong design. So if you want to build your own aquaponics setup, please just follow this six-step process. It's completely free, right? I redesigned it to help you to build your setup in good conditions and therefore to succeed in aquaponics. The second gift is for people who already have aquaponics. A very common problem we have in aquaponics is that we got the leaves of the vegetables that are turning yellow. And the reason why is because basically in aquaponics we sometimes need to add some minerals, otherwise the vegetables have some deficiencies. So if you have this problem, I made a special video about it as well, and you can have access to it in the description of the video. It's the free bonus video. If you are very interested into aquaponics, you can also have access to a webinar, a free webinar specific to aquaponics. I deliver a lot of information. Finally, you are probably aware that I wrote a digital aquaponics manual called The Art of Aquaponics. And you can have access to a free excerpt of this aquaponics manual where I add a lot of value and I give you a lot of my knowledge about aquaponics. So don't forget that you can have access to those four gifts on the description of the video, and I'm sure they're going to help you to develop your aquaponics setup and to produce your own sustainable and healthy food in good conditions. Bye bye. Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!